In this video, I'm going to talk about hours, minutes, and seconds in Excel. I had a problem that was sent to me by a lady. She was trying to calculate the time spent on each task and total them. And so the first big trick in working with hours, minutes, and seconds in Excel is you need to separate the hours, minutes, and seconds by colons. So let's put in the first one, and let's go 8. Let's say they started at 8, and they started 8:05, and then another colon, and then they started at 8:05:00. And then the end time would be 10:30:25. Now, you can subtract these, select the end time minus the start time, and you're left with the actual time that was to complete this task. Now, you can also multiply this. So we have 2 hours and 25 minutes and 25 seconds. Now, if we're going to do this every day for a week, so we multiply it times 5, and there you go. That's how many hours you're going to spend on this for the week. Now, if we just wanted to calculate and it works out to just hours, you're still going to have the rest of the formatting in there. So, for example, in our second example, we have 10:45:11, and our end time is 10:50:30. Now, if we drag down this formula that we have here, we end up with 5 minutes and 19 seconds. Now, if you don't include the zeros for the other to add the formatting, you won't be able to add these numbers properly at the end. And once again, we can drag down this formula here. And so if they did this for five days in a row, this is what the time would be. And the last one we're going to do is we're going to do for when it's just seconds. So let's go 11:01:03. And then we're going to go 11:01:55. The difference of that is only 52 seconds. Now, it's important to be able to add both the hours and the minutes, even though it's 52 seconds. So if we're going to sum these, so I'm going to do an automatic sum there so they can calculate how many hours they've spent doing these tasks. They've spent 2 hours and 31 minutes. And once more, if we can multiply this, and then you can get and bring this down again. So, if you carry all your digits, you are able to subtract your time to get the actual time that was accrued. You're able to multiply your time to get the time times number of days in the week. And you're able to total your time. So, it's important that you carry the formatting with the hours separated by a colon and the minutes separated between that and colon seconds. This is how you work with hours, minutes, and seconds. Please subscribe.